personal narrative. Somebody with your age wrote this. This is the author of this paper. Standing backstage, I want you to identify if the introduction has one of these techniques. Okay, so pay attention. Standing backstage, I could feel my heart thumping in my chest. Just relax, my friend Jenny whispered. You're ready for this, I nodded. Jenny was right. I've been practicing my song for the school talent show for 6 weeks. Still, picturing an audience packed with kids, parents, and teachers made me want to run out the door. So do you see any or identify any of these techniques in the introduction, Savannah? Vivid description? Yes. So what was the part of the vivid description?
Because he felt his heart pumping.
He was, or she was telling you that, describing how his feelings or her feelings, right? Isaac, anybody else? Jackson?
Dialogue.
So she was talking to?
Jenny.
Who was her friend, right? And see, they said, just relax, you're ready for this. So, exactly. So they are, do you, now that we read the introduction, do you want to keep reading about it?
Yeah.
Is this interesting?
Yeah.
Is it telling you what the story is going to be about?
Yes.
Yes. What do you think it's going to be about? Alonso? A boy or a girl? Did you put something like this in your own introduction? Could you use any of these techniques? I'm not telling you to write the same story. I'm just telling you, would you use the same techniques for your own story? Yeah? Okay. Very good. So let's keep reading, and let's see how the body of the story connects with the introduction. Yes, Melanie? It makes you read for the way he or she is describing it, and you want to know if she is going to do well or what is going to happen at the show, right? Okay, let's keep reading. Too late for that, I thought, as Mr. Peterson announced my song. Jenny gave me a nudge, and suddenly I was on the stage. Standing in the spotlight, I grasped the microphone and belted out the lyrics. I heard my voice pour through the speakers and feel the room. Going well, I thought to myself, don't mess up. So that was the second paragraph, okay? So she's not telling you yet everything, but she told you a little bit more what happened after, right? And then it's going to continue with the third paragraph. Let's see. I looked up at the sea of faces. So this is good describing comparison, because
the sea has no faces, but it's there because the sea of faces is like a crowd, right? It's describing you in a different way. So the auditorium was dark, but I could see hundreds of eyes staring back at me. The smell of candy bars and popcorn filled the room. I hope Jenny is saving some for me, I thought, as I started the chorus one last time. So we finish the third paragraph. So it's describing more and more, right? And can you see how he or she is describing a little bit more and more about the experience? And it's just one experience. It's not like 3 days of things. It's just one moment that she's making it big and describing it. So let's read the conclusion. As I finished the song, the audience began to clap. Yeah, Katie, one kid yelled. You rock, screeched another. I took a bow and walked off stage with a smile plastered across my face. How many days until next year's talent show? I asked Jenny. So by the last question, how do you think she felt?
Good.
Good. Good. Why?
Very happy. Not nervous anymore.
Not nervous because it was already done, right? And what else? Humberto? How do you think this person, Katie, at the end of the story, we knew that it was a girl because of the name, right? Katie, how do you think she felt? At the end, was she still nervous? Happy?
Yeah,
happy. So?
So accomplished.
Accomplished, very good, that's a very good word. That's a very good word because accomplished is like, oh yes, I did it. And she feels good about herself. Jackson?
Excited for the next talent show.
Yeah, she was asking about when is the next one? She was ready for the next one. So see, this is an example. And it's not very long, and she's explaining and describing a few things, right? So this is an example of a narrative. This is the full narrative. It's not just the introduction. The introduction was a few sentences, about 5 sentences long, and she said a lot of things. Okay, I'm going to read you a book, but it's very short, and maybe a lot of you have read this book before. It is called Where the Wild Are. Okay. And they made a movie.
Yeah,
but it was very different. It was a book very different from the book.
I
love this book. I used to read it to my son, and he was very excited when he was like 3 or 4 years old.
Yeah, I love that.
So, Where the Wild Things Are. Raise your hand if you have not read. This book is very famous.
That's
okay. Very, very famous. Okay, so pay attention and let's identify the introduction and see how this man, the author, wrote the introduction. Where the Wild Things Are. This is one of the characters. Is one of the wild things. My son had this for, he's now 16 years old, and he had this when he was 3 or something like that. Look at this picture. What do you see?
A boy
pretending, playing around. And what is it? What does his face look like? Can you see his face? Like a monster?
Like a cat?
Angry? Yeah.
So
look at the poor doll or the doggy here. This toy is hanging. So he's trying to create something here. Okay, I didn't read it. The Nightmax wore his wolf suit and made mischief of one kind. What is mischief? Jackson, Isaac?
Kind of like doing wrong.
Yeah, exactly. Travesuras. Travesuras in Espanol. Lauren? Ashley, please pay attention to this, not to Lauren, okay? And another mischief. What mischief is he doing?
He's chasing the dog with a fork, with a fork, like a beast or a monster. Look at that here. So he was sent to bed without eating anything. Do you think that's the introduction of the book?
Yeah.
Okay. That very night in Max's room, a forest grew. So he was in, the story was real at the beginning, right? Because that could happen. But then it turned into fiction because the forest is growing.
Yeah, because
that's my favorite part. So, and grew. Now he's happy. And grew until his ceiling hung with vines and the walls became the world all around. So he has in the forest. Now there's no room anymore. And an ocean tumbled by with a private boat for Max. And he sailed off through night and day. So here's his name on the boat, Max. Let's see what's happening with Max.
I think he ate something.
And in and out of weeks, and almost over a year, to where the wild things are. So he's going to go meet the wild things. There's a kind of a dragon-looking wild thing. And when he came to the place where the wild things are, they roared their terrible roars and gnashed their terrible teeth. And roll their terrible eyes and show their terrible claws. So is that scary?
No.
Do you think Max is scared?
He's scared.
Till Max said, "Be still," and tame them with the magic trick of staring into all their yellow eyes without blinking once, and they were frightened. And call him the most wild thing of all. So all the wild things call Max, "You are the wildest of us from the mountain." And made him king of all the wild things.
Oh, yeah.
He was the king, Max. "And now," cried Max, let the wild rumpus start. So they started shouting and dancing and screaming, and they were having a good time. So could you imagine the land was shaking, probably from all the stumbling from the wild things? And though they kept hanging from trees, and do they look happy?
Yes.
Are they wild things anymore?
No.
They look nice to Max, right? They were nice to Max. So he became the king. The crown, and he was the leader of all the wild things,
the leader of everything.
"Now stop," Max said, "and send the wild things off to bed without their supper." Who said that at the beginning of the story?
The mom.
So he did the same thing to them, right? And Max, the king of all wild things, was lonely and wanted to be where someone loved him best of all. Then all around, from far away across the world, he smelled good things to eat. So he gave up being king of where the wild things are. So what do you think he's feeling, John? Alone? Hungry? Yeah, probably hungry because he was sent to his room without his supper, right? Well, how do you think he feels?
Sad.
Is he disappointed?
he wants his mom, right? And his room and his bed and probably his dog. And that dog, hanging dog from the court. But the wild pigs cry, oh, please don't go. We'll eat you up. We love you so. And Max said, no. The wild things roared their terrible roars and gnashed their terrible teeth and rolled their terrible eyes and showed their terrible claws. But Max stepped into his private boat and waved goodbye. Let's see what happened now. And sailed back over a year and in and out of weeks and through a day. He was sailing for the whole night, one whole day. Finally, arrived and into the night of his very own room where he found his supper waiting for him. So his mom was kind to bring him supper, although he was being punished. And it was still hot. So this is, this book is short because it has very short sentences. Did you notice that?
Yeah.
Can you imagine all the wild things while you were reading? Did you imagine in your head a forest with monsters and beasts and dragons? So that's what you're supposed to do when you write your story, okay? Let the reader imagine what you have in your head. And sometimes it's hard because sometimes you have a lot of things in your head, but then you can't put it in words. You start writing and describing. And then you can also, with your Chromebook, you can help and find a few words like synonyms and things like that.
When I was smaller, I remember that being a bit longer.
This book?
Yeah.
Oh, maybe because you were littler. And then, I remember when I used to live in Mexico. And then when I came back, I remember things where I used to live. And I remember them bigger. And then when I came back as an adult, they were so small.